j'espère que vous allez très bien. Mbote na bandeko ne supposa ko landangai lelo na ko partager na bino vocabulaire na anglais. So when you hear somebody's talking about the web browser, think about Microsoft Edge, Google Chrome, okay? So we go here. Microsoft Edge, Safari, Google Chrome, okay? Microsoft Edge, Safari, Google Chrome, okay? These one are the browser, okay? So same thing with these, okay? These are the browser, all right? So we got like Firefox, Internet Explorer. You see this one? We don't use it anymore. I just put there for you guys to see it, okay? We go here. Devices. So when you hear somebody say devices, think about like the money. We have the money. But inside of the money, we have a quarter, loony, $5, $10, $20, $25, $100, okay? Think like that, okay? So in this case, when I say devices, you gotta think like laptop, iPhone. These are the devices, even the scanner, the printer, okay? So when I come here, desktop is a devices. Laptop is a part of it. Tablet is the part of it. It's like when I say money. Let's say, for example, let's put like, for example, this is the money. This is $10 is a part of the money. Let's say a loonie is a part of the money. $10 is a part of the money. $20 is a part of the money. So in this case, think devices as a money, okay? So laptop, desktop is a part of the devices. Laptop is, it is part of it. It is part of it. Tablet, okay? So I'm just giving you guys an idea to understand. Mobile phone is a part of it. Printer is a part of it. Scanner is a part of it. So here we're gonna learn server. You're gonna hear about the web server, email server, okay? So this one is the web server, email server, the fax server. So the way it works, the web server, in case you don't get it, it's like this. Let's say you live in Canada. This person live in Africa. Now you wanna email this person something. Let's say some message. Now you're using Gmail account. Now here we have a web server. I mean the email server, this one, right? It's right there, for example. Now I live here in Canada. In Canada, okay? This one is Congo. So this one is, yeah. So when you email me something, you email me the message or something, what happened for me to receive the message, it's gonna go here, it's gonna travel here, okay, and here, okay? It doesn't go straight, like it doesn't go like this. For example, goes here, come to me, no, it doesn't travel like that, okay? Just think like a post office. When you let's say I live in Canada, you live in Congo, and you wanna mail me something, it's gonna go straight to my house? No. What do you have to do? You go to the post office, you drop the mail there, and then it's gonna deliver to my place. But you have to go different places, right? So same thing. This one behaves as the post office. You see, so in your house, you have the modem, inside of your modem also maybe has a router. Now, inside of your router, it has something we call DNS. It has something, it's called DHPC. But this thing is not a computer courses. I mean, this course is not a computer courses. I'm just giving you guys an example. In case you want to watch my computer courses, please visit my website. Everything is there, okay? So I just want to show you guys how the message travel, okay? We come here. We have the client server, the file server, the print server. Again, client server, file server, client server, file server, printer server, okay? We got application server, proxy server, game server. Again, application server, proxy server, game server, okay? We got database server, name server, file server. This one is okay. Database server, name server, file server. We come here, we got Apache HTTP server, Windows server, FTP server, okay? We have, if let's say you want to study, you decide to study software engineering, software development, software technician, you're gonna hear this a lot. We say website, web page, tag. You're gonna hear this a lot about the open tag and closing tag. You're gonna hear this a lot, a lot. So you're gonna see something they put like this, A. And the other one is like this, A. So this one, we call this open tag. This one, we call this closing tag. Now, this one inside, we call this the element or the character. Okay, you're going to hear this a lot. This is what I'm talking about. The element, the HTML, the head. So this element, if I go back, this is the one I'm talking about inside the element. This is the element. This one inside of it, this one we call the closing tag, open tag. This one we call the closing tag, okay? So we have the element, the HTML, the head. We got the title, the body, the open tag, the closing tag. This is what I was talking about. So you're gonna see something like this, okay? And maybe let's say, for example, P. And we have something like this again. So this and this, we call this open tag. This one is open tag. This one is closing tag. You may say how? Because of this. Now, the P, the one inside, we call this the element or the character, okay, in English. Now, I always use the Google Chrome when I am explaining to my clients about the website. I always use the Google Chrome when I'm explaining to my clients about the website. What does HTML stands for? Now, if you take a look here, we have I am. Here we have So, when you at university, you writing, make sure you write this one. This one is okay for speaking, but not writing like academically. Don't write like this. You write like this one, okay? Because if you write like this at university or college, you're gonna get zero. Or maybe half of it, half of the price, the point. But write like this. What does HTML stands for? Okay. We come here. HTML stands for hypertext markup language. This one it sounds like markup language. What is a web server? Who invented the web server? Why do we need a web server. Okay, so I'm gonna stop here for today. So thank you so much. You guys take care. Bye bye.